Hi, this is James Cook of the University of Maine at Augusta, and I'm shooting this video in the woods to talk about different levels of measurement in research. Now, I'm a social researcher, but one of the things that I like about research is that you can apply it to any situation. So we're going to apply it in the woods today. We're going to talk about nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio levels of measurement. And let's talk about trees. I love trees. Let's talk about them. Here's a tree. This tree has a characteristic. It's a conifer. So, great. Conifer is what? It's a kind of it's a kind of tree, a variety of tree. We might call it the variable tree variety. I'm sure a botanist would have a better term for it, but I'm not a botanist. But I notice back here there are a couple of other trees. I'm going to shake them. This one, that one I couldn't shake, it's so big. But both of those trees are deciduous. They're maple trees. But the broad category I'm going to describe is deciduous tree. That means that their leaves fall in the autumn. These needles will stay on the tree all winter long. So deciduous versus conifer, those are nominal differences in trees, between trees. So the variable type of tree, if I measure it as conifer or deciduous, is a nominal level of measurement because there's no order to those. You can't say a conifer is more tree-y than a deciduous tree, or that a deciduous tree is more variety-ish than a conifer tree. It just doesn't make sense. There's no order to those categories, so it's a nominal measurement. Okay, so let's think about another variable about trees, height. Some trees are taller than others, right? We could say, you could probably guess, this tree is a short tree. We'll call it short. This tree is a medium height tree. And that big tree up there, wow, that's tall. So we could call that tall. We could call a second one medium height, and we could call another one short. Those have an order to them, right? Short is shorter than medium. Medium is shorter than tall. Medium is taller than short. We could put them in an order, which is why we call that kind of variable ordinal, because it has to do with order. Well, the neat thing about measuring concepts like height is that you can measure them in different ways. So let's say we wanted to be measuring a ratio variable, okay? We could do that with a measuring tape. So this measuring tape, I could decide, I'm going to operationalize height, and I'm going to say, well, it's the big numbers here, inches, on this tape, and I'm going to put it at the level of the base of the tree and extend it in a fashion perpendicular to the surface of the forest floor until I get to the top, which is the highest point of the tree. That's what I define as the top. I'm trying to be as specific as possible in my operationalization. And let's say that's about 80 inches. Okay. Now let's say I measured another tree and it turned out to be 160 inches tall. So if I measure height as number of inches tall from the forest floor, then that's a ratio variable. Why? Because there's a specific, meaningful distance between the individual inches, right? There's an understandable distance between them. And there's a true zero, which is the forest floor. And I can calculate a ratio of their heights. And that part is really crucial. So if I have one tree that is 80 inches tall, and I have another tree that is 160 inches tall, then that second tree, I can say accurately, is twice as tall as the first. That's what a ratio is. So I've skipped over one level of measurement, and that is nominal ordinal interval ratio. So let's think about an interval measurement of height. And an interval level of measuring height would have units, and the units would have regular gaps between them, meaningful gaps, but I couldn't calculate a ratio. Now to think about that for trees and tree height, we have to get outside the box a little bit. We tend to take for granted how we measure height, that you go from the whatever floor you have, forest floor, the floor in your house, if you're measuring your kid's height. But really, there are other ways to do it. I might not have myself a handy dandy tape measure. I might have another gadget. Maybe that gadget is an altimeter, and maybe that altimeter tells me how high above sea level I am. Okay? And that's what I have, and so that's what I'm going to have to measure with. And maybe I'm going to measure this tree, and I'm going to find out that the top of this tree is 500 feet above sea level. And then I'm going to say, well, maybe there's another tree, and its height is 510 feet above sea level. Okay. Now, and then I would say the forest floor is maybe 490 feet above the sea level, okay? So I know that this tree, being maybe 10 feet tall, let's say we imagine, and I know that that second tree is 20 feet tall, but I've measured it in a different way. I've measured it as number of feet above sea level. And because I've done that, I'll have 490 feet for the floor of the forest. I'll have 500 feet for the above sea level for the top of the 10-foot tree. And I'll have 10 feet above sea level for the 20-foot tall tree. The thing is, though, if I try to put a ratio of the measured sea level height of the top of the two trees, I'll have 510 divided by 500, which would seem to indicate that the difference, the relative difference of the two trees' height is really quite small, 10 parts out of 500. Whereas from a ratio point of view, right, I know that one is really twice as tall as the other. If I try to inappropriately calculate a ratio using sea height level measurement of height, I will get the difference in height wrong. And that's why it's an interval measure, because the zero isn't true according to our conceptual definition of height, which is distance from the forest floor. If the conceptual definition of height is distance from the forest floor, I have to measure it that way. Otherwise, I'm going to get it wrong. And I'm going to come to an inaccurate conclusion, which is why it's important to know the difference between nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio variables.